We are out here at the Maidu Summit Consortium lands in the Tasman-Coyum Valley, where about a year ago, we relocated a family of 7 beavers. One of those beavers swam downstream and actually met up with a naturally occurring beaver in the valley. And since that time, both family groups have reproduced. We have to be pretty quiet because the beaver family is inside this lodge right now. They will spend the majority of the winter in this lodge, only leaving to access their underwater food caches that they reserve for feeding in the winter. All of these beavers were captured from areas where their damming activity or burrowing activity was impacting infrastructure. By translocating them to this area, we have given these beavers a second lease on life. Now they have the opportunity to survive and do what they do best in a location that can really benefit from their damming abilities. We also released 3 families of beavers to the Tule River Tribes Reservation. They were placed on 3 different creeks on the watershed that are all connected hydrologically. They are 3 distinctly different genetic populations, and the hope is that these populations will eventually reproduce and their offspring will continue to reproduce and add additional beavers to a growing local population.
They are nature's Swiss Army knife. The things they can do are amazing. They create habitat complexity by creating dams and slowing down the rate of water so it recharges our aquifers.
This is the largest of the network of dams that the relocated beavers have created here at Tasman-Coyum. As you can see, this dam spans all the way across this wetland complex. It's holding back an immense amount of water. It stretches nearly 100 meters in length. And the reason that this is where their largest dam is because just upstream is where the beavers decided to place their lodge. The beavers have built a series of dams from this pond moving upstream to the upper pond. These dams function as water storage, but that water storage also expands the riparian zones.
Originally, Yellow Creek, the main stem just flowed right through here before the beavers built their dam. But now that we have a dam here, the water is being pushed this way toward their dam complex.
We are finding in some of our scientific work that when beavers are on the landscape in the Sierras, the way they can recreate wet meadows serve as a fire break that slow down or even stop catastrophic wildfire running across our meadows in the Sierras.
When there are these drought and wildfire events, these beaver wetlands function as refuge for a multitude of other species, including some of our state's sensitive and listed species. These locations are monitored pretty heavily, but typically non-invasively.
What we have here is our pit antenna system. This is our large battery. This powers the pit antenna for roughly a month, a little over that. That powers this actual antenna right here, and it puts out kind of a 3-foot radius in either direction, picking up pit tags. So yeah, this reader will pick them up, and then we got a high-tech cinder block here to weigh it down in the stream, and that's basically it. So it'll log all the pit tags that pass over it the entire time it's on, and then we're able to download this data remotely over a Bluetooth connection when we come out here. So we simply just have to haul it out of the water, change the battery out, and then download the data, and it's ready to go for another 30 days.
What we're doing now is we have one of the beavers is tagged with its own unique frequency with a VHF transmitter. So I'm triangulating to try to find out where that signal is coming from, and then we can locate where that beaver.
We also use aerial imagery to detect changes in surface water capacity of the landscape. The beaver restoration program was formed because We recognize the value that beavers can provide on a landscape. And so we are putting beavers back into those portions of their historic range where they can build dams and create wetlands that protect our landscape, not just the wildlife, but also the people of the state from effects of climate change like drought and wildfire.